Woman, lift your head to face me. Let the tears flow, even if they burn like the fires of mortar against your skin. I see the pain that they don't. The pain that intensifies like a bullet piercing repeatedly. They shoot words that scar, and the verbal abuse hits for six on a pitch you know too well as home. They pull the trigger using words, tones, actions that trigger the trauma you've endured, and they think nothing of it, and it hurts. Pain. Your mother gave birth to you through pain and called you the apple of her eye, only to later blame you for her own pain. She released pain onto you while saying the prayer of Jabez every night, trying to convince you that you were not him. Pain came in the form of a broken heart as you searched for love in others and other places because you felt abandoned by the people who once loved you. Every piece of yourself you gave that wasn't reciprocated, you tried to ignore and pressed on. But instead of healing, you chose destructive cycles. Pain came in betrayal when he took advantage of your sleeping frame to then act as if he was innocent, leaving you as an empty shell. Pain came from the twisted idea that you weren't good enough by the way they treated you. When you extended your hands to those who publicly treated you like shit, he called you bitch. Pain was translated into anger and it caused a chemical imbalance in that pretty little head of yours. You tried to block them out. Them. The ones who told you that you were the problem, so you believed and changed to satisfy everyone else, but still ended up miserable. See, pain is the only stability that you have ever known. The itch, it signifies the craving that lingers. I am barely holding on to the breath inside my chest, clutching to hope to avoid another attack. I long to hit that high, the feeling of mint in my lungs. 3 days since my last draw. I'm addicted to a stick that hides the pain in 3 to 5 minutes, just as quickly it fades. But for everyone's sake, I held on 3 to 5 minutes longer, a temporary lifesaver and a long-term life taker. Hallways, locked doors, silence. Words whispered from each door saying, make a choice. Who will you choose? Fear or love? Commitment or satisfaction? Too open to reveal contentment and curiosity, contentment smiles, flooding memories of rage, tears, forgiveness, and joy, while curiosity peaks down the hall with 9 lives, 9 chances. An energy compelling with respect, guarded walls, hands extended like wings of an eagle. A promising future, a lasting one. Contentment shones, remember me? Showing the commitment I vowed, the patience I've portrayed by waiting years for growth and titles, while curiosity tells me it'll wait for me. It's there to catch me the fall when contentment is no longer enough. I spin with rushing thoughts and the darkness consumes me, leaving another day for the choice to be made. You chose to love me. You chose to do so at a time where I thought I was ready. But as time progressed like a cheetah chasing its prey, I had come to realize that I wasn't. But I loved you as intensely as I could. Let's cling to the ideals of what unconditional love is supposed to be, giving each other space as far as the north is from the south or the moon is from the earth. Because time isn't making the heart grow fonder, it's ripping me apart. Yet you're patient, understanding. Every bit of the person I wish I could be. Then at times, I wish to never be. I require attention that you can't give me. You know, my mind races. Dover Rally F1 races when I'm left alone after days, weeks, crash. You vowed to be there after each crash. Occasionally you resembled my knight in shining armor. Other times you left me bleeding from my chest as my mind was wrapped around the going too fast. Yes, a car crash. That's the side I never wish to be. Unreliable. Unconditional love. Remember? I become agitated, biting at the insides of my cheeks, saying, I'm not going to get upset because you're already stressed. I'm supposed to be peace. You chose to love me. I tell myself I'm not going to be petty. I said I was ready for you, and then I slip. You always hear me apologizing, and it's because I can't love you the way you love me. The wounds aren't healed. This internal battle of whether I'm supposed to leave you to start my growth or stay for more reasons than love is exhausting. Then I hear your voice and I remember, through it all, you still choose to love me. And so I stay. Unconditional love, remember? Tell me you still see us when you look into my eyes. My breath halters. My words skip letters the way we skipped rocks on the pond when we first learned love. Leaves on thick branches don't cover us the way they used to. The heat of the sun burns through angry words blazing from our mouths at each other. I thought this was love. When did we purchase weapons? When did we deploy to foreign countries making ourselves enemies? This isn't a war. I can still see love in your eyes. Can you see them in mine, or did you go blind?